Seagull doesn't even know there's tectonic plates under there.
Gotta teach him.
Hello, Earth and Space Science. Now, if you know anything about me, you know that I am a fan of rocks. Some have even called me a geologist, and by some, I mean me. I love being in nature, and mountains, and beaches. And when I found out that our Earth is just one giant conglomeration of moving rocks, I knew I had to say something about it. Hello, and welcome to News. I am a weather reporter. Today's top story... earthquakes. What about them? I bet you're wondering. I sure am. Oh, one second, I am getting a call. Yes? Oh. Interesting. I will let him know. I've just gotten word of an earthquake warning for an earthquake that seems to be headed directly towards this very direction. I guess I'd better hurry up then.
Earthquakes are caused by friction in tectonic plates. The tectonic plates are giant flat rocks upon which our Earth's crust sit. When they move, they send waves that shake the Earth, causing earthquakes. This actually leads me to volcanoes. How do those crazy exploding mountains happen? When the tectonic plates move under another, it will sink into the Earth's mantle, causing magma to rise above the surface of the Earth, which makes a volcano. Now, mountains are created over long periods of time, and it happens when tectonic plates buckle in on each other and shoot upward. This is how mountain ranges are made. What's that? The earthquake is happening. Sorry, I'm having a hard time picking. This is the ocean. You might be wondering, why are we talking about the ocean? Well, earthquakes can happen underwater, caused by seafloor spreading, as well as other tectonic activity. Seafloor spreading occurs at the divergent plate boundaries. When tectonic plates slowly move away from each other, heat from the mantle's currents makes the crust easier to move. The crust will rise, forming a mountain or hills on the seafloor. Mid-ocean ridges are mountains under the ocean, and these will occasionally form a new seafloor and lithosphere when magma rises from separating plates and spreads across the old oceanic crust. Lastly, subduction zones. At subduction zones under the ocean, the seafloor goes under the continents and is recycled as magma. This happens along the Ring of Fire. What a perfectly timed transition. Washington. Seattle, Washington. A danger zone for earthquakes and tectonic activity. But why? Well, Seattle is located on the Ring of Fire, which is a trail along the Pacific Ocean, which features many volcanic eruptions and earthquakes. It is home to a deep trench and is where tectonic plates meet. This is why it frequently has earthquakes. What does this mean? Our current location is unfortunately at higher risk for earthquakes. It's all okay though. That just means I get to make cool videos such as this one. Not to mention, tectonic plates take a very long time to move, so we probably won't have another earthquake for a while.
Unless...
is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring, bound by wild desire. I fell into a ring of fire.
And that's what an underwater volcano looks like from the surface. The end.